prison, they approach it trying to have a foot. They shall be in every place in the cities and great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord.
I think I got it. Yep, I got it.
Anyways, like back to let's go back to Jezebel too, because she was trying to kill the prophets. Same shit gonna happen today. You know, the government gonna try to kill the prophets and round them up, shit like that.
Why do you have a camera? Why do you have that?
There shall be in every place in this next city a great expression upon those that fear the Lord. They shall be like mad men, sparing none. We say Revelation, great wrath. Because you know we have a short time, so he said it'll be like a madman, a crazy ass person. Going crazy, killing people, busting people's doors, shooting people in the head, raping their sons, raping their daughters, everything. What's crazy? What's wrong? What's
down? They said they just got here. They should be out here.
He said, but still spoiling and destroying those that fear the Lord. For they shall waste and take away their goods and cast them out of their houses. Then shall they be known who are my chosen, and they shall be tried and blown in the fire.
Oh yeah, we're going to know who the chosen is. Like right now everybody's battling. They say, I'm the man of the Lord. No, you ain't. We the men of the Lord. You know what I mean? Everybody arguing. We're going to find out who is real and who's fake when the time of Jacob's trouble comes. You know what I mean? That's coming real soon. When the shit hits the fan, we're going to find out who's real and fake. You know what I mean?
I have this TV called Jacob's Ladder. It's about this guy who went insane.
Yeah, we've seen that.
Vietnam.
Got that Italian in it.
Yeah, everyone I know that served in the Vietnam War, I was a hippie. I was protesting. That's why I didn't go to college. I was protesting the Vietnam War. Like John Lennon, Martin Luther King, and anyone who had his purity left at that time. Neil Young says, you can't even protest the Iraqi War. Neil Young says, well, Bob Dylan's been quoting the Bible off and on since he couldn't make up his mind. Am I Jewish? Am I Christian? Am I a song and dance man? That's the way I can. Nice talk to you. This is the edition to the King James Bible?
Yeah, the Apocrypha. It's in most Bibles in the world, have it.
Praise the Lord.
He's kind of cool, but kind of annoying. You know what I mean? Because he don't want to stay on subject with us. You know what I mean? He
can't keep focused.
Yeah, he can't keep focused. He got so much he want to talk to us about. That's what it is.
Full of
pimps,
right?
Yeah.
Full of shit.
We've been talking to that dude. You remember that guy?
He's alright.
Yeah. We've been talking to him for years. But remember, years ago, though, he was telling us that he was a Buddhist, a Hindu or something. But now, all of a sudden, he's believing in the Bible. Hey.
Because he's finding out to be his truth, man. You know?
Hey, look, we said the Lord's only coming for these people, and he said he agreed with that. Hey.
Verse 16:75. Hear, O ye my beloved. Talking about Israel, but mainly be let you learn. Say if the Lord, behold, the days of trouble are at hand.
You still need Wi-Fi?
Nah, it's working.
But behold, the days of trouble are at hand, but I will deliver you from the same.
Yeah, the days of trouble, that's just coming, man.
Part of the days of trouble are people gonna turn against each other. They gonna try to turn us in and shit, you know? Narcissist shit.
Oh, like the IUIC, bro.
Right.
IUIC, you know, the leader of their church, if you want to call it that, is a detective. So what you think he's going to do?
Right.
Yeah, you know Nathaniel? No, he's a detective for the NYPD.
Nathaniel 7.
Came to find out he's a detective. All kind of them is in law enforcement.
You remember Crosby's voice is
7-4. Yeah, some of the lawyers or something.
Lawyers and shit. Cops too.
Can't trust no
there's
fucking
cops too.
They go out teaching straps.
Right. They're fucking crazy, man. If I didn't have my CCW, I ain't gonna still come out here strapped.
I don't know why they scared. Ain't nobody gonna come up against me.
Yeah. Right. They love everybody.
They calling the Israelite woman a queen. You remember back in the day Well, we call some whore like a straight up whore. She's like,
that is credit.
He said we called her a bitch. He's like, what you say?
Yeah, they broke it out with a nigga.
They said you can't talk about our women like that.
It's your sister.
Hey, well, then you gonna say the Lord, because the Lord called them whores.
He said they had stinky pussy too.
He did. He said they pussy stinks. Get out of here, bro. That's in the Bible.
Right.
It says in the Isaiah 3rd chapter, it said, the, you know, the instead of sweet smell, there shall be stink.
It's Jezebel. Back out this bitch right now, man. There are probably three bitches right now.
Yep, Jezebel.
And then,
Jezebel had a wicked ass daughter, too. Bro, wasn't it Athaliah?
Let me read this 1 Kings 18. I'm starting to start at 1. I think this is the chapter, bro. Hold on. Yeah, it's a long ass chapter. I ain't going to. I'm trying to make sure this is the chapter where she got stumped again.
Who, Jezzy?
Jez.
Jeezy? That's like your boy Jeezy. Jezzy. Jez, that's not kind of sound like Jiz. Jezebel.
Right.
Jezebel, the Lord of Jiz.
Well, it tells you here that she did wicked too. Here we go, 18:1, 1 Kings. And it came to pass after many days that the word of the Lord came to Elijah in the 3rd year, saying, Go, show thyself unto Ahab, and I will send rain upon the earth. And Elijah went to show himself unto Ahab, and there was a sore famine in Samaria. And Ahab called Obadiah, which was the governor of his house. Now Obadiah feared the Lord greatly, for it was so. Jezebel cut off the prophets of the Lord. And Obadiah took 100 prophets and gave them from him.
Right, because Jezebel and Ahab, they was killing all the prophets. And there was only a few left, and it was Obadiah and I don't know how many prophets exactly, the number. They went and hid out in the cave. I was about to tell you that thing.
Yeah, it said took 100 prophets and hid them by 50 in a cave and fed them with bread and water. And Ahab said unto Obadiah, Go into the land unto all fountains of water and unto all brooks. Peradventure we may find grass to save the horses and mules alive that we lose, not all the beasts.
Right, but we could be like that one day, had to go and hide it. Mm-hmm. You never know, man.
Well, we're going to it, man.
You know what I mean?
For real. That's going to be some fun shit.
We have pilgrims.
Yeah. That's why your homies are
always in Genesis. He's always been the body there.
Yeah, he disappeared.
I'm a
pilgrim.
I've been a pilgrim since I came to you. You know how many times I've moved? Hell, you've been following right behind me. Shit. For real, man. That's just the spirit of the Lord, man. Working. That's the spirit of the Lord working. Oh, where was I at? Woo. It's humid, ain't it?
It's a nasty day. I'm tired as hell, too. I woke up at 3 in the morning because someone decided to call me in the middle of the night. I woke up, bro. I was like, oh, what the fuck? Yeah, I couldn't go back to sleep. Then I had to go get tags and shit, so fuck.
So they divided the land between them. The paths moved out. Throughout it, Ahab went one way by himself and Obadiah went another way by himself. And as Obadiah was in the way, he called Elijah. And he knew him and fell on his face and said, Art thou that, my lord Elijah?
I pronounce it as Wada Da, yeah, it's locking, you know what I mean? name, brother?
What's up?
Amar.
Kill Amar.
Yeah, Amar. Y'all talk. Yeah.
Amar.
Yeah.
Amar.
Yeah.
Amar. There's two ways.
We used to kill them on Facebook back in the day, man. We got next, man.
There was a dude we used to teach with, too.
Cut him off, but he told him about it one time, and then we like, all right, maybe cut him off, the spirit, you know, switch, take one, you know, I mean, so, yeah, so,
Yes. He's looking for a way out.
Don't cut him up.
He ain't like the Corey. Like, yeah. He's just teaching by himself, so he ain't like Corey, man.
Maddie, you got a problem with the elders, man. He had a problem. The spirit had to be in different ways, though. Like, me and Andy had to pick him up. Like, he was like, the spirit had to be different. Now you see him now, man. Like I said, we're very real. We just did a video on him, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this nigga trying to rap now.
And then, no. He had a problem with, like, you know, he wasn't used to other guys speaking like he was. So he did an attitude he couldn't even see.
Yeah. Now, then he joined the HOI. He started monster camp to camp.
The mother camps, they'll take the track.
Oh, yeah, they will, man. They will, man. You know what I'm saying?
So we ain't got to worry about y'all coming with no flat earth thing.
Oh, hell no. Hell no, man.
Flat earth.
No.
Get the feelings right now.
Yeah. That's it. I said, because y'all teach the tie, so y'all already know how his spirit, you know what I mean?
He saw us go through some crazy shit.
I'm pretty really good, man. Because like I said, we've been battling people up there, man. Like, we just can't take you. Back-to-back, we do Saturday and Sunday. Some brothers, we got it like that. Some brothers can't make, like, the worst schedule. Some brothers can't make Saturday on Sunday, too. But that was our initial day, was Saturday, but then we had it to Sunday camp. I set up. But it's way more of them on Sunday, though. It's like about 5 or 6 of them on Saturday.
Yeah.
And then, like, the rest of the camp is, like, about to get, like, 3 or 4 today. Yeah, because we started off, it was, like, 4 of us. Me, my 2 brothers, it was Todd. And then, like, the spirit, like, now we're, like,
you got all your brothers out there. How many brothers you got?
I got 2.
It's my brother. It's my actual
brother. He was more manly. That's rare, though.
Yeah, man.
Usually, you know, the family turn against you.
Yeah, but that's an experience, though. Yeah. Jeremiah's, I take the city to,
that's good.
I got a brother actually from the two.
My brother used to come out with me. White things getting out there.
Yeah, man.
My brother's too busy sucking dick.
Oh,
you know what I'm saying? For real, man. So I know they ain't
fucking. Yeah,
hell
no.
For real.
Yeah, man. That's
the way that works, man. Yeah. They some thugs. They some rough thugs, too. Sucking dick. Fucking niggas' ass.
Damn.
That's
they'll be the ones, though, man. The niggas, like, hey, at least it's good. Yeah, but y'all can get started. Like I said, we going to fall right along, so, man. We just be whole folks and stuff like that.
I got my iPad like that, but they don't got that.
You got the Yayan in there too?
Oh yeah.
Hey, one day for us to come back, or y'all come up there, brother.
Yeah, we gonna have to kick it back.
Come up there.
Roses out a couple weeks. I mean, not a couple days ago. So
see
a
price when I see one too, man.
Yeah.
We went to New York one year. And that same weekend we went down there, GMS moved to another location that 1 week, man.
I was like, damn, that was so weird, though.
You talking about 1 minute?
We,
I went to jail.
Oh,
how long you been there?
Like, they pulled us over, they thought we were drug dealers. Damn. That's what they told. They took this car, took it all apart. And then I had like a little tiny pocket knife like that. I didn't know you weren't allowed to have knives in New York.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if it's like military tools, but I think it's legal. You can be like,
you go open carry in Ohio. Oh, okay. Yeah, you can.
Uh-huh.
It's the same way for knives and shit. I think
it's got to be. Yeah, that's statewide, though. Pretty cool.
I'm going to go away from the stadium.
I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I'm going to go to the stadium. I
Oh yeah, we right there. Why don't they like
in the
middle of
downtown?
If you write like in the heart of
They say Columbus is one of the fastest growing cities.
It probably is. It's the fastest.
They just build it and build it and build it.
Malachi,
yeah, look at that. They won't stop
this. Cleveland, man, they got Detroit right there. Niggas come from Detroit. Buffalo. They come that dirt, they doing their dirt, you know? Just Cleveland seems to be that centerpiece where everybody goes.
Yeah,
I'm
off
Ohio.
Yeah,
right.
Like,
it's something about Cleveland, it's a small city, but it's something about that.
It used to be one of the hot spots
for
the mob.
Oh, it was
true. It's called the Jones and all that. The Rockefellers.
Okay.
That used to be AC.
Yeah, because it's a building. You see, like how that building is, like right there. It's like right where you teach, that's like a building saying Rockefeller on it. Like, right,
that's where you got to start, was in Cleveland.
Okay.
Well, I don't know about the start, but I know. Standard Oil was located.
Yeah, because you know that's an industrial city, so.
I mean, they fixing things up now. Downtown, they fixed
it
up.
Yeah, they
got a nice little restaurants, they fixed that city up. Ever since LeBron won that championship, man.
Oh, yeah. Man, you look at the flats now, man. All this is like brand new.
Yeah.
Everything's brand new. I remember I used to ride through there, go to the bars and all that. Everything's crap. Observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day. Not in Bible times. Ain't that what they say? Oh, that was Bible time.
Hey, and that's why we always say we still in Bible time. That's
right,
why it's
right,
the year
right.
2017 AD. You know what I mean?
That's right.
Time itself is based on the Bible.
So it says, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Cursed shall thou be in the city, and cursed shall thou be in the field. Cursed shall be thy basket and thy store. Cursed shall be the fruit of thy body, and the fruit of thy land, the increase of thy kind, and the flocks of thy sheep. Cursed shall thou be when thou comest in, and cursed shall thou be when thou goest out. The Lord shall send upon thee cursing, vexation and rebuke in all that thou settest thy hands unto for to do, until thou be destroyed, and until thou perish quickly because of the wickedness of thy doings, whereby thou hast forsaken me. The Lord shall make the pestilence cleave unto thee, until he hath consumed thee from off the land whither thou goest to possess it. Let me look up this word real quick.
Yeah, I got a dictionary.
Pestilence. We got the blue letter too.
We might as well call this bitch.
Taking all kind of stupid shit. Jake be walking with his bitch. See a pole. They don't let those poles spin, man. Because you don't know. They believe in those superstitions and shit, man. They believe in all them other gods. All them other, you know.
Oh, we just going to spirit. Eric, we do everything by the way.
Yeah, that's how we work too, man.
If somebody got something to say, just say it.
That's right.
As long as we ain't getting out of order. Yeah, you know,
out of nowhere. Let me use your cell phone, man. Cornish. Oh, man. You're crazy, man.
What we say, pestilence?
Yeah, pestilence.
If I can find it.
I'm in Deuteronomy 16.
Man, I'm
Deuteronomy 28 and vexation.
I got you. I thought I had it. Yes.